Welcome back to Proactive. I'm joined on the line now by Jo Battershill from Anglesey Mining. Jo, the long wait for your Parys drill results is over. Can you talk us through them?
Yeah, thanks, Tom. Thanks for having me on. We've just released the last of the drill results. It feels like an eternity ago since we finished the drilling. The drilling started at the end of November, early December last year, and was finished towards the end of April. We've had some cracking results from the first two sets of assays, and as we sort of alluded to the market on a number of occasions, that these last two holes, the reason they were delayed somewhat is that we wanted to get the holes logged geotechnically, which had to be done before they could be assayed, and it took a little bit of time to find some consultants that were available, given the global mining boom. So anyway, those results are in. The geotech logging has been done. The metal assays themselves have come back very encouraging. Just as a bit of a reminder, you know, the primary reason for the drill program, it wasn't exploratory. It was actually sort of infill drilling, which is to increase our confidence in the resources that we think are there and we now know are there. We will embark on a resource update immediately. In fact, we've already started that work, which is where those drill holes and those assays will be put into the model and to verify the existing model. And as you'd expect with an infill drilling program, yeah, there's some wins and some losses. But fundamentally, we're very happy with what we saw and generally saw mineralization and good mineralization where we expected to see it. So as part of the mineral resource update, the key aspect for me is to increase the amount of material that we can convert from the inferred category, which is the lowest confidence category, into the indicated category. I think it's important to point out, prior to this drill program, 79% of the white rock mineralization was already in the indicated category. So this is about just really fine-tuning some of the edges of the ore body, and so we can then put it into a new optimized mine plan going forward. Very, very excited by what we've seen, and it just really just keeps increasing my confidence in what I've seen here since I joined the company just over a year ago.
Okay, fantastic. Now, could you give us a sort of a rough idea how much value do you think these results add?
Oh, what a great question. In terms of share price value, I don't think much gives the market confidence at the moment. It doesn't matter what we do or what we say or what any other company says or does. The market's a pretty tough place at the moment, as everyone knows. In terms of value internally, it's almost, I wouldn't say invaluable, but to get that level of increased confidence is really quite critical when you're taking a resource into a development scenario. We would hope over the course of the next few months next few weeks, while we do this mineral resource estimate, that we should be able to see some resources lifted into the measured category as well. Now, the reason that's important is when you're going into a mine development scenario, your measured category can go into a proven reserve, and whereas your indicated is a probable. So it's all levels of confidence, and really that level of confidence, it helps us as a company plan the potential operation, but it also gives a lot of comfort to potential financiers. And the higher categorizations you can have in your resource, and the more of it, then obviously the more that speaks in terms of volumes of confidence for financiers. The other aspect that we'll take forward from here, and again this is all just a sort of the next natural steps from the drilling, is we want to do some more metallurgical test work. This project has already had a 2,000 ton bulk sample taken back in the early 90s, and there are very few projects that have got a preliminary economic assessment that would have 2,000 tons of bulk sample. Most projects around the world at a PEA stage or a PFS stage would have some bulk samples from some drilling, which would be in the potentially hundreds of kilos, not thousands of tons. So in terms of metallurgy, we're pretty confident and we're pretty relaxed about what we know about the metallurgy. But there's been some significant developments in pre-concentration techniques since the early 90s and current days. And so really this next round of test work, now we've got all the assays back. I'll be going up to site with the team over the next week to 10 days to go and select the samples from all these drill holes that will go through into another round of metallurgical test work. And really, this is just to do some trade-off test work on the best pre-concentration method, whether it's a dense media separation or whether it's a an XRT, X-ray transmission sort of wall sorting technology. We've already got test work from 2007, which demonstrated the DMS, you get 40% mass rejection for 3-5% metal losses. So yeah, to put that into context, when you look at the drill holes that we've released today, or yesterday, sorry, I mean, one of the drill holes was 29 meters at a sort of a nickel equivalent, sorry, a zinc equivalent of 6.5% zinc equivalent. If you run that material through a dense media separator, what that suggests is you would lose 40% of that volume, which would be the low grade stuff. So you would naturally upgrade that. So I mean, 30 meters at 6.5% would end up being 20 meters at plus 10%. So it just dramatically alters what you put through your plant and your process plant, and ultimately has a significant impact on lowering costs. So this is all real sort of mine planning stuff, and it will just feed through into those next study phases. So look, we're pretty relaxed. And also, I'll touch on it. I mean, one of the other things that we did mention was, we've received the results from the conceptual tailings and designs for site. We are looking at, a dry stack tail, which is, the way that things need to be done. I mean, I think it's the anniversary of the Aberfan disaster today, which was a terrible, terrible event. And tailings is front and foremost of all mining companies' minds at the moment, given disasters in Brazil and stuff. So dry stack tail for us is the obvious sort of starting point. And the studies demonstrate quite comfortably that for the enlarged production scenario that we envisage in the preliminary economic assessment, we have more than sufficient area and space to dispose of the tailings in a dry stack method. So look, we're very, very confident about that and very happy to see those results.
Well, glad to hear it. And it sounds like you've got plenty to be getting on with in the coming months, Joe. Yeah. So I'll leave you to it and let you get on. But it was a pleasure to have you here on Proactive, and we hope you'll be back again soon.
Thanks, Thomas. Looking forward to chat soon. Bye.